Well, and this is, it gets even crazier, okay? So I never forgot going over to his apartment and told us this story, talking about weird for a kid, you know, to digest. And so that happened. News to me. And it's this 30-year-old case solved by DNA. And it said something about Ted Bundy was really not the killer. And I swear to you, Ken, at that point, I knew exactly who they were talking about. And as it turned out, it wasn't Bundy that had killed the body. The whole time he thought it was. And then DNA proved differently. And the guy that actually did it was in prison as you know, they were writing this. And I just remember seeing him, like, I seen him just a couple of times where you can maybe sleep a little bit. But yeah, we were under the understanding that it was a Bundy deal. Oh, do you? But my name is. No kidding, huh? Boy, she's quite an author. Well, you know now, if you're at 200th and Pass Highway, and you go down 200th, like down that way at the bottom of that hill, where the golf course is. As you're going down that hill to your left is where they're putting the trails and all that. That there, we used to ride on motorcycle side. And I remember my brother telling me this story. Him and one of our good friends who since died from epilepsy, they were out there one night, and they said they heard this scream that just made your hair stand. And you know, they ended up finding out he was down there. You know, it's really weird. Come to find out that guy there, he was all around me growing up because he lived. Well, my buddy Scott, do you remember over here named Scott Layton? Okay, well, he grew up on 176 right there by Valley View Elementary School. Well, right where you, if you were coming from South Center up 188 there, it was just to the right, just before that four-way stop. Well, Ridgeway lived right behind. There was a fence dividing him and Ridgeway. So there was that, and then my wife and I later on in life, when we moved out to like Lake Geneva area out in Federal Way, we were out there, and that's when they arrested his ass on 364. And that was like 5 minutes from my house, if that. So the whole time, you know, around the airport area, he was, you know, around. And then as it turns out, we moved out there, and then he's still around. Yeah, that was kind of eerie. And I swear that once I seen his face, I'm like, damn, that face looks familiar, like I've seen it. And you know, he went to Tyee. Yeah. In fact, I always joke when I talk to people, because I tell them that Tyee didn't learn so much that we need to mention anymore. I said, damn, I'm going to go.
You should laugh, but I don't even know if you ever do it. Tiny is in the one thing, so.
And then as it turns out,